Hello, I'm Kurt Browning, Pasco County Superintendent of Schools. As you probably know, the district is in the process of redrawing attendance boundaries for a number of our schools. This process is never easy, and we don't take any pleasure in having to reassign students to different schools. But with the number of new homes being built in Pasco County, the school district has to redraw some school boundaries in order to keep the schools as close to capacity as possible. Overcrowded schools do not present ideal safety or learning conditions. In addition, the fact is that some schools near our overcrowded schools have capacity that needs to be filled. The district does not receive adequate funding to build schools for all new communities, and we have an obligation to all Pasco County taxpayers to use the resources we do have wisely. Our Director of Planning, Chris Williams, will now explain in more detail our rezoning process.
So anytime we do a school rezoning, we put together what we call a boundary committee. And that boundary committee is made up of the principal of every school that potentially will be impacted. And then those principals pick two parents from each school who sit on the committee. And along with those folks, we also have representation from our planning department, our transportation department, our exceptional student education department, and the administration. The only thing that happens before the boundary committee meets is that the superintendent has determined that we need to do a rezoning. So there's no lines been drawn. The only thing that's been decided is that we need to do a rezoning. So the committee is tasked with redrawing boundary lines for a couple different reasons. Usually it's when we build a new school, or when we need to rebalance populations where we have some overcrowded schools and next door we have undercrowded schools. And so the committee is tasked with redrawing the boundary lines to balance those populations out and or make a new boundary for a new school. The first meeting we go through a lot of data, a lot of maps. We talk to the committee about what their task and their role is. We provide the guidelines and criteria by which they are to draw the lines. And we give them a lot of background information, demographic information, housing and growth information, socioeconomic information, feeder pattern information. We break out a lot of the subdivisions and provide the number of students who live in each of those subdivisions. And so we cover all that information. And then once we do that, the committee then starts to look at those different pieces and those subdivisions, and they start looking at what might make sense as far as moving one area to another area. The committee's role is to come up with a proposal that ultimately will go to the superintendent, and the superintendent will review it, and then ultimately it gets presented to the school board. And so the school board we'll hear it in two separate readings and public hearings. And so ultimately the school board will vote on it, and the school board can vote to approve the recommendation that's presented by the committee. They can vote to not approve it, or they can send it back to the committee for further review or alteration. There's several opportunities to provide input. After the committee has done its work and come up with a proposal, then what happens is we have a parent meeting hosted by one of the schools, and it's open to all parents to come, and we show what the committee has come up with, show what the proposal is, and talk about the different programs that are available at each of the schools, talk about what programs might be available at schools they're getting rezoned to. And then we open it up for questions and input and feedback. And so at that time, parents can ask whatever question they want. And also, some of those questions might be, well, why did the committee draw the line here and not here? And so we can answer those questions. And then again, it's an opportunity they can provide feedback. And so what happens after that is after that parent meeting, then the committee will come back together and review the parent input and look at the boundary one more time and decide if they want to tweak the boundary lines based on the parent input. Once that happens, again, it goes to the school board for two public hearings, and that's two more opportunities that the public has to provide input on the boundaries, and they can speak directly to the school board and either voice their disapproval or voice alternative plans to what the boundary committee has come up with. The committee meetings are open to the public, but it's not an opportunity for public input at that time, because the committees are doing the work that they've been tasked to do. So that's not an opportunity. Certainly people can come and observe, but it's not a time that people can speak or talk or try to interject or give input at that time.